Put a little bit more light under the eye here. Just going to remove these initial structural lines. Put a bit more tone under the arm here. More tone under the beard here, moustache. Just shading the back of the hand. Knuckles. You indicate where the knuckles are. This middle finger, a lot higher. Oops, wrong finger. Just indicate where the hair is coming through. Start to bring this arm in. Going to figure out where this arm, forearm comes through now. bring the hair down. Back of the head. Comes up. Try and find out where this nose comes in. Just tighten this up. Angle of the nose comes out. Indicating where the cheek comes down on this, comes round. This is the top lip. Top lip comes down. Bottom lip. So the chin comes down. Mm-hmm. measure to this ear. So the back of the ear is here. The lower part of the ear. Shadow shape of the ear. Hairline. Comes down. And then the neck. Neckline. Back of the neck. Up back of the head. Get the hair, some of the hair in. So look to get this, start to get this hand in. get this other knuckle in. So we'll just try and get the rest of this hand with the hairdressing scissors in. So we've got the thumb, the bulbous part of the thumb muscle comes down. Just need to check how far it comes down. So the knuckle, the underside is there, and then the actual thumb comes out and then up, so we see a little bit of the shadow on there, fold of the palm. And then we're into the ring of the scissors, which kind of come out doesn't even look like his thumb is connected to the scissors. And they kind of come through to the main shaft, which is coming in this direction. So there's the body of the scissors. This kind of comes across. And then we've got this finger which comes over the top. And the point of the scissor comes down. All the way down. And tail end of the other part of the scissors there. So then this main finger, index finger, is in there. And then palm comes up, and then little finger. So coming around the back of this finger, which is where the knuckle is there, behind the scissors, comes in and then out, and then we're into the thumb, back of the wrist. So then we can lose some of that. And then his arm carries on through the back here, and the shirt comes through and then actually down the front there. So then this is all pretty dark, which is the far arm. So we'll put that in fairly dark. Underside of this hand. There's some overlap on these fingers. Just a small indication where the edge of the finger is. I'm not going to put the whole line in because that can often make the fingers feel too fat or a bit too heavy. So side. Then we can put a little bit of tone on his shirt there. So the underside of the beard. Just a few stronger marks. Actually, the top edge of the hat needs a bigger brim. That line's not in the right place. So the hat should actually come up and over. That's a bit better. And then we've got this band going round the hat. Dark on that. It needs to be dark on this back section. And then a little bit of lighter shading down the construction line a bit more. Can darken up all of this then. Coming out front of this hair. Just show the fingers up a bit better. Fill this space shape in. Keep it fairly even. Narrow the finger out a bit. Down to the knuckle and then into the other finger. Back of the scissors. And then we're into the hair. Straighten the finger out a bit. And then this arm, if I just smudge all that in a bit, I can then take some of the charcoal that's on my fingers from the bit I've smudged in and just put a bit of tone through this arm. So it's not so white. Through the back of the thumb, into the centre of the finger here, hand rather. Just put a little bit on the fingers, just to knock them down a little bit. And then I'm just going to put some dark through this chap's hair. Nice and dark all the way down here, back of the head. And then he's got his moustache, or beard rather I should say, down here. Up into the top lip. Darken up through the neckline. ear shape to go in. Bit of tone around the eye. A bit of light through the hair, just with the putty rubber. Continue the dark down. Knock all this down. Link some of these shapes together. Darken this up a bit more. Touch more tone in the beard. A bit of light through the back of the hand. Just put a bit more tone around the eye. Darken this up a bit more. tone through the ear and the hair. Also the side of the face, a little bit more tone. Up into the forehead. Need to knock this bit of tone down, it's a bit too dark. Put a bit more dark just to even out that shadow a bit more. Just going to use the putty rubber and just tidy up this underbrim. Pick out a bit of shape in the ear. Bit of light. Even that beard out a bit more. Bit more tone in here, in the under eye. Tone under the nose. Moustache. We'll tone underneath the bottom lip. bit of light onto his edge of the shirt. More tone in the beard. Face needs a bit more tone in it. So very lightly, just putting some more tone through the side of the face. Bring that brim of the hat out a bit further. Tone on the nose itself. Not quite as dark as the rest of it. Under the eye. Few darker marks. Light in the cheek, forehead, touch on the nose. More tone through the back of the hand and the arm. Bit too light. Just knock all this down a bit. Thank you. a couple more dark marks in here. See how that looks. A bit more tone just through here. Just darken up down here a bit more. And with that, I think the drawing is finished.